Okay, we will go ahead and get started. I would like to thank you for joining the Texas Instruments new product update webinar. Just a reminder, this is a weekly series every Thursday at 9 a.m. Central Standard Time. A few quick announcements before we get started. This webinar will be recorded and available online at www.ti.com/npu. All phone lines have been muted, so if you have any questions, please use the chat box and we will try to answer you in real time, or you can contact your TI salesperson or field application engineer. And with that, I will pass it over to our presenters to introduce themselves.
Thank you, Suzette. Hello, everyone. My name is Jeremiah Vo. I'm part of the Gate Driver marketing team. Thank you for coming to this new product update. Today, I'll be presenting to you TI's latest automotive low-side gate driver, the UCC27624Q1. This has just recently APL'd, and you can find it on ti.com if you'd like to learn more information or would like to order samples. Our agenda for today, we'll start with what is a low-side gate driver. Then I'll go over our one-pager, which I'll use as a way to show off technical specs that differentiate itself from competition and legacy parts, as well as to drive home the points I want to get across about this UCC27624Q1. Then we'll have our overview slide, which will have features, system benefits, and then applications where you can find these system benefits. Some additional key features will follow, which are technical features in depth, meant to promote understanding of why certain specs were designed in. Next, we have common topologies, which are where you can find the UCC27624Q1 and how the UCC27624Q1 can help address a lot of problems in some applications. Lastly, we'll have our getting started page, which will be full of resources to start evaluating this part. Additionally, we have our applications engineer, Kevin Costa, who is in chat, and he'll answer any questions that you'll have throughout this presentation. So first, to understand what a low-side gate driver is, we need to start with what is a gate driver. Well, on the diagram, you can see the gate driver is sandwiched between the microcontroller and the switch of a FET, such as a MOSFET or an IGBT. Gate drivers amplify control signals from a microcontroller to produce high current outputs for semiconductor switches. So typically, this gate driver will take a low voltage input from a microcontroller, amplify it, and output a higher voltage for the switch to switch the load. The UCC27624Q1 is a dual channel low side driver. Dual channel just means it has two inputs and two output channels, and low side drivers mean that they have the power switch reference to ground. Low side gate drivers need to have high drive strength and fast switching characteristics for increased efficiency, and also have some protection from transients with negative voltage handling, which I'll go more in depth as the presentation goes on. Here is our one pager for the UCC27624Q1. There's a lot of words on this slide, but I'm going to use this as an opportunity to highlight some key specs and also what you should get away from this, including this is a plus or minus 5-amp, 30-volt dual-channel low-side driver. This part boasts high robustness and great switching parameters. Speaking of switching parameters, I want to bring up two in particular. It has a 6-nanosecond typical rise time and 2-nanosecond max delay matching. Rise time refers to how long it will take to get from a low to a high state. And delay matching is how synchronous your two outputs can output at the same time. These two specs in particular are top notch compared to a lot of competition. Speaking about robustness parameters, it has an absolute max negative voltage handling of negative 10 volt on inputs and an absolute max VDD voltage of 30 volts. I'll talk more about the first one later in the presentation, but for the second one, this 30 volt VDD provides flexibility with different operating voltages, and having a high operating range helps alleviate some problems with overshoot at VDD due to board noise. This headroom is helpful and it helps increase robustness. Next, this is pin to pin with our legacy devices, as well as tens of other different parts. Pin to pin just refers to its pinout being the same between parts. So if you look at the bottom right-hand corner, we have some pinouts of the UCC27624Q1. And what this will mean is that this pinout will be the same with legacy devices or other parts. And lastly, we have an operating range from negative 40 degrees Celsius to 150 degrees Celsius. Once again, this is helpful for flexibility and allows this to be used in a lot of different environments. Here's the overview. Once again, there's a lot on this slide as well, but to break it down, on the left, we have our features and the system benefits of those features, as well as some applications and system benefits where you can find a low side gate driver. So starting back on the left, the UCC2764Q1 comes in two packages, the D package and the DGN package. And to go over some of the key features and some system benefits, we'll start with negative handling on the input and output pins, which is negative 10 volts on the inputs and negative 2 volts on the outputs respectively. This helps remove the need for clamp diodes, which reduces cost and space, as well as allowing this part to operate accurately in many harsh environments and noisy conditions. I just mentioned it's pin to pin with legacy parts in competition, and how this is helpful is that you can be able to drop in the UCC2764Q1 into your gate driver circuitry without needing to redesign your circuitry. This allows you to update another low side gate driver with a gate driver that has increased technical benefits, more robustness, or can meet supply demands, such as the UCC2764Q1. It has a strong plus or minus 5 amp drive current. The higher the current allows for quicker switching, and this quicker switching increases efficiency by minimizing the losses. This also has a 4 volt UVLO, which is also known as under voltage lockout. This is essentially a function that makes sure that our device will do nothing until the supply voltage is high enough for predictable behavior, which helps us design a robust part. Essentially, if a power supply voltage drops below this UVLO, the device goes into a protective standby state to prevent malfunction. This can also help increase switching frequency and reduce your system size. And lastly, we have the tune in and second delay matching, which once again is the turn on difference between your two output channels, how synchronous those can be. This is useful for precise timing applications, such as a PFC controller, where the inputs of both channels are driven from a common control signal from the controller, and also for paralleling outputs to create a single output of double drive strength. So the paralleling of outputs, that is just another way you can use a dual channel low side gate driver, you can make it into a single output, and this just helps for more flexibility. On the right, I want to introduce some of the applications before we go into them more in detail later. We have our onboard chargers, or OBCs, DC to DC converters, automotive heating, and DC-AC or AUX converters. These are just some places you can find an automotive low side gate driver. Next, I'd like to speak about some highlighted features once again, just to promote understanding and also why we designed this into the UCC2764Q1. So the first thing I want to talk about is output noise immunity. Here on the left, we can see the UCC2764Q1 and two competitive parts, comp 1 in the middle and comp 2 on the right. On the left of each diagram, you can see a lot of noise at the beginning, and this test is essentially to see what can survive high frequency noise. On the left, we can see the UCC2764Q1 survives this high frequency noise, whereas comp 1 misses the signal, and comp 2 produces a false signal. This is helpful due to the high robustness and the 30 volt VDD and reverse current handling of the UCC2764, which allows us to handle high frequency noise and transients at the output pins, regardless of how much noise there is on the input state. Next, I want to talk about thermal performance. Once again, on the left, we see the UCC2764Q1 and a competitor part on the right. These are under the same board and under the same load conditions. And we can see, looking at the top left-hand corner of each picture, we can see that the UCC2764Q1 is a whole 5 degrees Celsius cooler than the competition. This allows us to be able to drive heavier loads at higher frequencies, and this will be beneficial as we can achieve higher system power density, excuse me. Lastly, I want to talk about component savings. So in a legacy part or potentially a competitor part, when there is not enough robustness built in, a way to alleviate protection against transients and noise are clamp diodes, here outlined in red. However, since the UCC2764Q1 has this built-in protection, like the negative 10 volt negative voltage handling on the inputs and negative 2 volts voltage handling on the outputs, that allows us to be able to remove the need of these clamp diodes. Removing these clamp diodes allows for savings up to 12 cents in a system. And while 12 cents doesn't seem like a lot, this is 12 cents per gate driver. And in a large scale application or mass production, this could be significant when you combine all of that. And this is all due to the inherent protection that is built in to the UCC2764Q1. Next, we have some applications. So on the left, we have the topologies of some of the system applications I talked about earlier and where you can find a low side gate driver outlined in orange. So to go over them quickly, we have the interleaved boost PFC of an onboard charger. Onboard charging just refers to charging a battery on a hybrid or an electric vehicle. We have a 12 volt, 48 volt DC to DC converter. This steps down the voltage from a 48 to a 12, which is manageable to allow for powering of electronics in your car. Next, we have a PTC element. So these heating elements can be found in cars for defrosting, for heated steering wheels, for heated seats, and typically have some sort of built-in protection for overheating. And lastly, a DC-AC inverter, which converts the battery to AC current for 120 volt power plugs in your car. So if you ever plugged in your phone into your car or maybe use a handheld vacuum for your car, this is what allows that to be used as a common power plug. So some challenges that can come with these applications are on our right. So I just want to go over them briefly to talk about how the UCC2764Q1 can help address some of these problems. So the first challenge is efficiency. Optimizing your system and minimizing losses is something that every system wants to achieve. And with the increased drive strength and good fast switching parameters of the UCC2764Q1, we've optimized the switching to have as little loss as possible. Additionally, another challenge that's presented is reliability and robustness. Well, I'd mentioned about the 30 volt VDD and how that has the headroom for a margin of safety, as well as having that UVO threshold, which is optimized for low side powers, which allows this to help alleviate some of the problems with that challenge as well. And lastly, lowering the total cost and the size of the system. This is something that every system wants as well. I just talked about a lot about the cost, how removing the clamp diodes can remove a lot of the cost when designing a system, but something else is removing the size, or reducing the size, my apologies. When you remove those clamp diodes, you don't have to design the circuitry that's associated with them. And that allows you to shrink your system to be more compact. And that is something that is useful for a system like in automotives. Here's our getting started page. We'd love for you to start evaluating the UCC2764Q1. And there's a handful of helpful links and content here that you can find on ti.com, from product folders to webinars to technical articles to the evaluation kits. And once again, we'd love for you to start looking at this and start reaping the benefits of the UCC2764Q1 and what it can do for your system. I'd like to thank everyone for coming to this presentation, and please visit www.ti.com/NPU for a recording of this presentation, as well as other great new products from TI. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Jeremiah. Do we have any questions that anybody would like to ask verbally?
Yes, I would like to find out if these parts are available and what is the delivery time.
Hi, yeah, this is just recently APL. So you can order samples, and samples off of TI.com get shipped very quickly out. I'll double check on the exact time, or maybe my manager in chat can help answer that as well. But these ship really quickly when ordered from TI.com.
Thank you. I would like, if you can send me that information, my contact is victorb@mcico.com.